You are currently working on, or you are about to start working on your statement of purpose for graduate school application, and you find this video, I'm glad you open it to hear what I have to say, because I believe that there are certain points I will make in this video that will be very helpful for you in writing your statement of purpose for graduate school application. I'm Dr. Emmanuel Akinboye. I have a PhD in medicinal chemistry from a research university in the United States, and I currently work in the United States as a scientist. Today, we are going to begin a series to look at the subject of how to write a great statement of purpose for graduate school application. And in this video, I want to highlight certain points that you need to put into consideration before you even begin to write that statement of purpose. Because I have assisted many people to review their statement of purpose, and there are certain things that I believe that should be put into consideration before you even begin. So let's get started. In one of the previous videos where I highlighted the differences between statement of purpose and personal statement, and also the similarities between them, it was emphasized that statement of purpose is one of the most important documents that you are required to submit for your graduate school application. The reason for this is because the statement of purpose is what establishes that you are a good fit for the program, and the program is a good fit for you, and why you want to come to that program, and what you accomplish in that program, and what you plan to do after graduate school. So you need to take it very seriously. So the first thing to put into consideration in writing your statement of purpose is to start strategizing and planning for writing your statement of purpose very early. That is one of the most proactive steps you can take. It can never be too early, and normally I advise people to start a couple of months before the time that you are expected to submit. I know that many times you are busy, maybe you are in your senior year now, or you have already left school, you are currently working, or you are engaged with one thing or the other, and it's very easy to say, I will start it later. But the truth is that if you start early to strategize and to plan, you have more time and you will be able to do a better job than if you wait till a week or a couple of days to the deadline of submitting your application package to the school. So start strategizing and planning early. The second thing is list out all your accomplishments, your credentials, your award, and everything that you want to include in your statement of purpose. Some of these are already in your CV or in your resume, but it's always a good idea to list them out on a sheet of paper, or you type them on your computer, so that you know that you will not forget any of these important achievements that you have had, which are going to be in your statement of purpose as part of what you plan to use. I've seen cases where, while I'm trying to help a student to review their statement of purpose, they remember something else that, oh, I should have put this in there. Oh, I didn't know that that was important, I should have put it. So every relevant achievement that you know that is part of what you have accomplished in school before, or at the current job that you have now, which you think can make your application stronger, I advise that list them out so that you have them at a close reach by the time you are writing your statement of purpose. So the third point is to start the actual writing early. First point I made was to start strategizing and planning your statement of purpose early. Strategizing that I mentioned in point one may involve your search for school, your gathering information about the school, about the research that you want to do, looking for the document that you are putting together, and things like that. Now, this third point is start your actual writing also very early. You begin the actual writing by the time you start putting together the first paragraph, the second paragraph, the third one, and you are looking at it and reviewing it. And you are supposed to start that early as well, because as you will see when we start going into the details about how to write it, there is a lot that is involved in that 2 to 3 page document that we call statement of purpose. So the earlier you start writing it, the better it is for you. You don't want to be overwhelmed on the day before the deadline. So I advise you to please start the actual writing a few months before the deadline. The fourth point is this: write the statement of purpose by yourself. I know that may sound like, what do you mean? The truth is, today in the age of internet, and we can find documents everywhere, and you can also find helpers who can help us, or professional writers who may want to help to write it. I do not advise that. My main advice is that you do the actual writing yourself. Please, do not plagiarize, because if you plagiarize, there are a lot of software that can be used to screen your documents, and the software can detect if you plagiarize. So please, you do not want anything to be against you. And another thing is, do not use professional writers to write it. Write it by yourself, because the statement of purpose is one of the important documents that the admission committee will use to see the quality of your writing. How well do you write? Because in graduate school, you are going to do a whole lot of writing. And if you are going for a PhD program, which is a research program, you are expected to publish papers, you are expected to do a lot of writing, both in the coursework that you are going to take, and when you start research, you are going to write proposal, you are going to write papers, and you are going to write all kinds of things. So put your best into it. There is nothing wrong in asking for assistance with review to help to check for error and things like that. But make sure that you write the actual document by yourself. The fifth point is this. One doesn't even need any explanation, and I will just simply mention it. Please use plain, simple, and correct and easy to read English in writing your statement of purpose. The next point is very important, because I've seen many students make this mistake, and it has cost some people their admission into the program. This is the point. Do not do what I call a one content or one writing is good for all strategy. This strategy is not a good strategy, and I will explain what I mean by that. What that means is that I've seen students who would just write their statement of purpose, and they write a single statement of purpose, and that generic statement of purpose is what they send to every school that they are applying to. They send it to every program they are applying to. This is not the right way to do it, and I'll explain why. In your statement of purpose, you have to describe the type of research that you want to do. By the time you get a little specific about what you are interested in working on, you will realize that the research that you highlight in the generic statement of purpose that you want to do may not be available in every program you are applying to and in every school that you are applying to. So it is important that you do your own homework and check the school website, check the program website, and look into the research that is being done in that program to be sure that you tailor that aspect, that particularly the aspect where you talk about your research goal and research interest, you tailor it to fit what the faculty members and the researchers in that program are working on. That you must make sure that you see at least 2 to 3 people who are working on the same area. Because if there is nobody working in that area that you put there that is your interest, what that means is that place is not a good fit for you. That is the conclusion that the admission committee will have, that there is nobody who will be able to supervise or advise this student if we admit this student here because of what the student is interested in doing. So it is important that you check and do the background research and be sure that what you put in your statement of purpose as your research interest aligns with what is being done within the department. And this information is easy to get through the website of the program, and also by looking at the profile of each of the faculty members who are involved in research within that department, and from social media as well. If the program have some presence on social media and you check their social media page, you can see information about ongoing research, and you can also go as far as reaching out to the faculty member that you are interested in working with and some of their students to actually check what they are doing to have more idea about their research work. That way, you are able to put in the right information in your statement of purpose. And the next point is this. Use a storytelling strategy in writing your statement of purpose. The reason for this is this. When you write your statement of purpose, you want to make sure that from the first paragraph to the last paragraph, the reader is interested in reading everything, because you have created a storyline. And the reader want to follow that story. Not tell many personal stories in your statement of purpose. in the previous point, I stated that you are supposed to use a storytelling strategy, which means that you create a story about your purpose. It doesn't mean that you are going to be telling personal story, because this is not really personal statement. Even if you put a little personal story there, it has to align very well with statement of purpose, because this is much more formal than personal statement. If you are asked to write a separate personal statement, there you can tell some personal story and use that to show your interest and inspiration. But in your statement of purpose, avoid telling too many personal stories. Don't use abbreviations, shorthands, and incomplete sentences in your statement of purpose. If your statement of purpose is full of things like this, what that may indicate is that you don't really know what the statement of purpose is about, or you are in a hurry and you don't have enough time to review and proofread and edit and write everything in a very clear way that will be understood easily by the committee members who will be reviewing your document. Now let's go to the next one. The next one, proofread, proofread, proofread. This one, we cannot overemphasize it, because you do not want any single typo, any type of grammatical error, or whatever it may be. You don't want it to be in your statement of purpose, because that would not show a diligent student who is detail-oriented and who is ready to do the type of great writing that is expected in your PhD program. So please, invest your time to proofread and make sure that there are no typos or grammatical error or any type of error in your statement of purpose. Last point, but not the least, and even one of the most important points I'm making for you here today, is ask the right people who may give you great advice about your writing to help you review and edit it, and look at different aspects of your statement of purpose to be sure that it is detailed enough. It contains everything that is needed to be included in it, and it is free of typographical and grammatical error, and is the most perfect document that you can turn in for your application to graduate school. I hope you find those points very helpful, and I want you to look forward to the next video where I actually discuss how to write the statement of purpose, and I show the guideline from paragraph to paragraph. Bye bye, and I will see you in the next video.